Well, it is found everywhere throughout our homes and it's often used by our kids. Baby bottles, kids' drink bottles, lunch boxes, food containers, the list goes on and on. And they're all usually made of plastic. We use it so much that most of us just take it for granted that it's harmless. But is it harmless? Here to enlighten us this morning is Dr. Joe Kosterich. Good morning to you, Dr. Joe.
Good morning, Tim.
It's not until you do a story like this you realise how much plastic we do have. We come into contact with in so many times of the day for various purposes. Can you tell us what are some of the dangers that go with it?
Yeah, look, I think dangers might be sort of too strong a term because people will say, look, these products are safe. Safe defined is they're not toxic, they don't kill you. The biggest issue is just it becomes cumulative. So as you said, they're sort of everywhere. You know, you go a generation back, we used to get milk in bottles, we used to have, you know, lunch wrapped in greaseproof paper. You know, there was much less plastic around. And particularly in microwaves is where the issue can arise. So the key thing, the key plastic is what's called BPA or bisphenol A. And the issue with some of these plastics is that they can leach a little bit out of the plastic and into your food. Yeah. And that particularly happens when it's heated up.
Okay, so yeah, so BPAs, I'm sure a lot of people have heard of BPA chemicals. Let's talk about some of the things that can exacerbate the risk when it comes to BPA. You mentioned heating up. What about filling up a water bottle? You know, just a normal bottle of spring water and then you refill it over and over and over and over. Is that a risk?
It's a smaller risk. If you leave it in the car and it heats up, that's probably not quite so good either. Look, I suppose these days there are alternatives, and I think that's, we'll get back to that point later, so I don't think people need to worry about this because it's not as if there's things that you can't do. The next question, people are probably saying, well, you know, what's the problem with these chemicals? And essentially, the BPAs tend to act as what's called a hormone disruptor. So obviously they're not hormones, they're chemicals, but they can bind to receptors within the body that are hormone receptors, and particularly the estrogen receptors. So there are, I suppose it is fair to say, associations with, and I think it's very important to say that these plastics by themselves do not cause any one single condition. I think that's a really important point. But they're additive to other things. So again, because they act like estrogens, which is the female hormone within the body, they have been linked with, as one of the causes of increasing rates of breast cancer. They've been linked with increase in breast size over the last couple of generations, rising rates of obesity, prostate cancer in men has been theorised, and also lower rates of fertility. So it's not a direct effect. It's not the only thing that happens, but if it's just one more little thing on the top of what might already be, you know, developing, then that's where the issue arises.
You mentioned they're cumulative, so if we're exposed to them more and more, once we've ingested these chemicals or they become, I suppose, at a harmful level in our systems, are we able to rid ourselves of that toxicity, if you can call it that, or does it just stay dormant in our system and it builds and builds and builds over time?
Look, short answer is yes, the body, like with any toxin, will get rid of it. With anything we ingest, alcohol probably the best example. If you have too much to drink, which is obviously not a good idea, as time goes by, the body gets rid of it. The more you've had to drink, the more time it takes to get rid of. They did some work in America. I mean, it was only a very, very small study and looked at people consuming actually soup from cans, which had a plastic lining, and found that after 5 days of consecutively doing this, their levels in the urine were close to double what the baseline level was. Right. But again, after another few weeks, it's eking out of the system. What was more interesting out of this was that something like 93%, could be 92, of Americans had traces of BPA within their urine. So it is very ubiquitous. At very small levels, it's probably not a major problem, but it is that greater exposure over time and in more things, and particularly heat. I do want to emphasise that. So if you have a microwave, and some people don't like microwaves anyway, that's a personal choice, but yeah, put it in something ceramic or that's not plastic.
Glad wrap, that seems to be one of the ones that cops a bit of heat. You'll pardon the pun, but heating things up where Glad Wrap is obviously microwave, coming into contact with the food seems to be one that people highlight as a risk.
Yeah, look, again, that's probably a bit less of a concern as if the whole container is plastic. So you get a lot of these plastic containers that say they're microwave safe, and they are, they don't explode in the microwave. But those are often the ones, because they are microwave safe, that because they're the harder plastics, that some of it can leach in. The Glad Wrap, if you put it over the top and it's not touching the food, to be honest, I think that's probably a lesser concern.
Yeah. All right, stick to glass and ceramic. Thank you, Dr. Joe. If you have any questions for Dr. Joe, you can get them to us. The address for Dr. Joe is there on your screen. Drop us a line.